Hello everyone, I'm Androman and welcome back to another episode of The Binding of Isaac Repentance. And so last time we did the first run of the save file of the DLC with Isaac and we beat Mom's feet. And now we unlocked the womb and I mean I unlocked Ace as well. So might as well try it. See if he got any changes this DLC. So far it doesn't seem like there's anything new about him except for the haircut. Also maybe a tiny bit slower, I think. And also, today is the 1st of April. So yeah, happy April's Fools? I'm not even sure. Also, yeah. I should be careful with Seraphine in this room. Okay. So this round should be pretty quick and painless. We unlocked Lazarus, that's nice. So I've seen my friend play Repentance a little bit. And there are quite some new things, it's just that most of them are on the alternate floors, like Cellar and Dark Basement. So yeah, we need to unlock these. Once we got Sinfoil, a really good item, Mortar Stones. A really good item for Azazel early on, since we do get a range up. An essential stat on Azazel because of his really short range, as well as damage, which is always nice. Even though Azazel has like the best base damage in the game, I mean base DPS, not base damage, but base DPS. If you don't get any damage upgrades, he will fall off either way in the womb, especially. Little old mushroom is kinda meh. I will donate more money. It's a donation machine. I need store upgrades. That's really all we need. The basic shops are really bad. Now imagine almost like half of the shops in the Binding of Isaac Wrath of the Lamp looked exactly like this. Like they had two items. Maybe 4 max, I think? I'm not even sure. Wrath of the Lamp was quite a while ago. Like what, Rebirth came out like 2013, I think? I think it was around 2013. So quite some time ago. And now we get the third DLC to The Binding of Isaac Rebirth. And Isaac went quite a long way, don't you say? Hey, what are you? Gigantic Bean? Okay, there might be a secret room up here. Let's just check. Okay, I don't think there will be. Yeah. Okay. We should look for the secret room. But at the same time, I don't feel like it. Hey, we got basement boy. And oh, what are those? Okay, that's interesting. I've never seen devil deals of like a single red heart and two soul hearts, but I will take monster money. Well, monster money. Well, so I'm drinking my coffee as I have just finished my breakfast. Okay, let's see. I'm really not sure what monster manual does. Why is the 6 charges? The farting baby comes along for a second room or a third room. Okay. Okay, I'm not really sure anymore. Is it like time based now? Also Seraphim or Guardian Angel? No, it's not Guardian Angel. No, it's Seraphim. He did quite some damage, not gonna lie. Okay. I shouldn't have come so close. And take stupid damage. Okay. How can I not take this? That's the question. I hoped we would get a bean combined with this trinket. Mom's spear would be really nice, but let's play with this. It seems fun. I mean, since now I know that devil deals are really weird in this game. And even though I had red hearts, it still suggested me paying with soul hearts. Yes. I think I should try to collect some more soul hearts. Okay. I wonder if I made like angel deals better, more viable. I really wonder. Would be nice. Maybe instead of making angel deals better, they just fucking dunk devil deals and made them utterly dog shit. Who knows? The Bible would be nice. But you know what would be nicer? Donating to donation machine and stored level whatever. Devil is better. In my opinion, there should be a secret room. And there is. Since it's Cave's XL, I don't really see a reason to finish it so quickly. We might want instead to try to get better items and maybe prepare to take on the boss rush. I think taking down the boss rush would be great. Oh my god. Since we really need everything, we need to do everything. And boss rush is really annoying. Since Afterbirth Plus, the best DLC out there to end the game ever. No cap. So yeah. Sorry for my coughing. As I said, it's pretty early morning. At least I think I said that. By early morning I mean almost 12 PM. Okay, that's really bad. That's some bad news. So yeah, it's 12 PM, but I woke up like an hour ago. I have barely eaten my breakfast and I started recording this episode. So yeah. Also, let's never blow up mushrooms again. I think it would be a good idea. As some of you may have noticed, the gigantic fart seems to be working on enemy farts as well. So that's a new one. Now, so far it doesn't seem like we'll be able to do boss rush. Our kit is pretty bad. Our stats are fine, but that's only because we are Azazel. But we'll get two boss items right now, and perhaps a deal with the devil. So we'll check this out in a minute. Also, by the looks of it, we might have a good chance to get a devil deal on Womp too. Because if we don't get a devil deal now, we'll have 100% on Necropolis 1 for devil deal. Okay. 100% devil deal depends on Necropolis 1. Not cool. I'll just deal with those. And then we have 33% chance on Necropolis 2, 67 Womp 1, and 100 on Womp 2. So it would be ideal to not get deal with the devil on Necropolis 2 as well as Womp 1. So we can go to Sheol on Womp 2. And that's a soul heart. And that's a new item. What's this to say, man? Don't mind me. I really don't mind a run with worst use. That means I can start not taking them for the entire run. Ooh, that's really nice. Okay, this gigantic parts are pretty fun. Like, look at the range. What is happening? This trinket is really good. I mean, we got like the best pin possible with this. I mean, maybe not the best possible, because the best pin is... Wait, what? But... I don't know how wait, what would work with this. Maybe the big... I think it would just increase the knockback effect of wait, what? Which is not that great. I don't think the fissures will be increased. And so I think the standard bin might be the best bin. Oof. Okay, these little pins are still pretty fun to me. I really don't know. Oof. Okay. Let's be careful. There's jumping PJs. Oh, okay. These pins, to be honest, they haven't hit me yet, I think, but they seem pretty dangerous. We have so much money, and how will we even spend this? We don't have the donation machine shut. Shut itself down. If we get the standard gambling machine, I think we might want to play it. Only because on the last save file in Afterbirth Plus, like one of the last items I had to collect was the dollar. I never played these machines. I only played the fortune telling ones. The variant with trinkets and soul hearts, the one that's actually pretty good, in my opinion. But the standard ones are, in my opinion, quiet, useless and lackluster. The dollar is nice, but the chances of getting the dollar are so small. Oh, what are you? Bombs are keys? Okay. I wonder, does this like change all padlocks in the run on the floor into a bomb padlocks instead of keys? Like opening an item room with a bomb? I don't know, maybe. Also, since I have free morning, because it's only... Oh, they increase the shot speed on this guy, that's for sure. I see this. I really wonder if it's... hard mode would be really nice, in my opinion, if it's hard mode, instead of just straight up increasing the shot speed on these guys. I think it should be hard mode. And I haven't read the patch notes at all, because I don't want to ruin the fun. What are you? Real Ammonite. Tacy, Hugh Jones, Lemon Misha. How long does this take? I think it's pretty long, but this is the bean. Oh, we did. What? This is the bean run. We increased the price on it. Don't sucks. Up to 7 cents. That's robbery in daylight. Whatever. The bean. The one and only. Oh, you cocky bastard. Huh? What are you? I mean, I play this. I don't have donation machine to spend money on. Huh? What is happening? What is it, some battery bomb? It seems so. Okay, I will blow this guy up. Okay, it was well worth it. I don't need so many bombs, I don't think. They changed them. Like, if you know some things about Afterbirth Plus, Rebirth and Afterbirth, what are you on Earth? Jesus! Holy shit. It's a tick? I think it's a tick. So if you know a bit about Afterbirth Plus, Rebirth and Afterbirth, the beggars could only drop something on the 6th row since the first one. Okay, that's pretty funny. Oh. So yeah, only on the 6th row. Also, this boss, to be honest, pretty cool. Okay, we get Fulfur and the pack. I mean, of course I'm taking the pack. That's free stats. Sulfur? No. I'm an Azazel, and I already picked this up last run. So yeah, where was I then? My memory isn't really all that good. Oh, so yeah, beggars could only drop the first drop on the 6th money or the currency they wanted. They would drop the first item only on the 6th one. And then it would be random or luck based, more like semi-random. But now it doesn't seem like. They seem to be random right from the get-go. Which is, to be honest, a good and a bad thing. Because you don't have the guaranteed payout on 6th roll. But, at the same time, you could get more things this way. Okay, we need to hurry up. Because, we have 4 minutes to complete Necropolis 2, beat mom, and we need to check out the boss rush. Okay, this is a mess. I don't really want to pay any of them. Okay, completely useless cards so far. I could actually. Okay, I can actually go back to the Devil Judgment, see what he has. To offer that was I wasn't looking. Okay, this is my bad. Let's see if we can still pay out to he took me down to. Yeah, that was again a mistake. This doesn't work. What? Oh, let me see it again. Okay. Now what is happening? Like, why can't I enter the boss challenge room with half a red heart from Devil Judgment and even 0 red hearts from Devil Judgment? Like, what? That's messed up. Like, what are the requirements now? Aren't even sure. And okay, let's just run through the floor. The bean is dealing some damage. Don't get me wrong. The bean doesn't seem all that bad. What are you? Did they just change the battery sprite or? Oh, that was messy. okay. Mesburg from Golden Chest. I wonder, did they change the field up? Okay, let's just go. We have Hermit. I think they might have changed the level up. Because after birth class, level up only did, I think, was decrease the standard. The standard's consumable spawn rate and increase black heart spawn rate. Almost like gap is there. What are you? Paper. Let's check out this. Book of Belial is pretty cool, but we don't need it. Absolutely not. And boss rush. Hey, there are some new items. Of course, chocolate milk would be great, but I will take this. There's a new music. What is happening? I completely don't know. Okay, does this make enemies kill themselves? I mean, kill each other? Ah, that's, if yes, that's pretty interesting. Yeah, they definitely are killing each other. Like, look what's happening, this item is completely busted from boss rush. Okay, that's really cool. That's a nice item if I ever seen it. Gabriel, just kill this poop. Okay. And the duration on this is like... Oh, Gabriel sounds, that's nice. Ooh, okay, I will think to this. Earthlings? I mean, I will just poop on that. Yeah. Oh, it's Loki. Holy, okay, that. That was spooky. Okay, okay, okay. That's... Also, did they change the boss rush waves? I think they might have added some new variants or maybe changed them completely. To be honest, I wouldn't mind. The previous boss rush was... super annoying. I hate it after birth class boss rush. So I hope they did change it. So it won't be as annoying. Okay. This tomato is really weird. I can't put my head around how it works. No, for a second I thought Gertie is shooting faster, but that would be like sadistic. That would be actually sadistic. Ooh! New horseman sprites. That's cool. Thank you. Yeah, these look nicer. They're almost like, yeah, more. Oh, Blastoised. That's a cool boss. Because Blastoised has such a low spawn rate on Womp. It's another boss like Fistula. I hope they made him spawn more. You still don't see them often. My favorite from the low encounter bosses are still Tyachnit. I think it's the cutest boss in this game. Yeah, this is bad. We are losing a lot of hearts. Yes, Azazel with the short brimstone do have his weaknesses. Even though his damage is really huge, like, some of these enemies are gonna be pretty dangerous short range. I should be super careful. Okay, adversary is like the fucking the spookiest boss in this game. Hey, what did we get? Aquarius, absolutely useless. A new item? I can't afford it. I will try to. In the secret room. But so far I'm enjoying this gigantic bean. It seems nice. No, we don't have to try to be as fast as possible. I don't think we'll be trying to do Hush with our current setup. I don't think so. Wafer is great. It makes this run a lot easier. I don't really have to worry about the Womp anymore. Okay. That's all, folks. So let's go to the Womp. Maybe we'll encounter some new things in the Womp. This is the first time we're going to the Womp in Repentance DLC. Okay. It's actually Utero. Okay, let's just... Okay, yes. So I think this delicious tomato is working only on boss enemies. I think that may be the case. Also, this Utero is so dark. What? And Tinted Rock might be a bit tricky, EP. Yes, in this Utero. And just go straight to the boss. I mean, okay, is there a Toma? Why is it so small? It barely even split up. Okay, that's a weird one. Cato Nine Tails? Yeah. Dimensional Baby should work with Brimstone this game? No? That's fine. It's fine. You gotta check some things. Okay, this is a warring room. Not so much for Azazel. But those enemies are annoying. We should look for Tinted Rocks as much as possible. Mainly because... Okay, this... What happened? Am I imagining or did multi-dimensional baby... Okay, the... It actually works, it's just the hitboxes are so small. Yeah, it like only catches it at the end of the brimstone. Seems like it. Okay, that was stupid. At least we have wafer, so we don't lose as much HP. Okay, we have only 33% devil deal chance, which is not ideal. But we can make do. A dimensional baby is completely garbage with Azazel. Confirm this for you, so you don't have to. But Seraphine though? It's fine with Seraphine. And Seraphine deals a nice chunk of damage. Yeah, I mean, just let me come closer before. Yeah, she does this. Okay, we don't have even the hash on loop. Again, I think that's it. We don't really need to hurry with Satan. Although I would like to hurry only because the SSL items are completely broken. Unless they got a nerf. Which I don't think they did. Oh, do we unlock the Eden? We did. That's cool. Hey. Next one might be Eden or Lazarus. That's cool. So yeah. Thank you everyone for watching this episode, and I think I'll record the next one in a row. So yeah, thank you for watching, and see ya.